fuck the what's next. Go cash your back checks.
Welcome.
How's it going, guys? Today we're doing another review. It is another prop review, and what I got for you today, we're gonna be talking about the Gym Fan 3D props. These are the ones partnered or whatever, or designed by Zoe a little while ago, and these are just about the only 5-inch 3D prop that you can get with any kind of regularity. I've looked around and I've tried to find other ones, and I rarely see any other ones. And if you do, you gotta order them from China, and they're gonna take 12 years to get here, and all that kind of stuff. So, those are the ones you can get usually, and they fly pretty good. They're not terrible for regular freestyle. They're not super aggressive as far as pitch, so they they don't just decimate your battery when if you're flying regular freestyle. You can kind of see, not the craziest pitch, but in 3D, of course, you're gonna hammer the battery a little more just because you're going back and forth, especially if you're doing like TikTok type stuff, those kind of things. But we are going to compare them to these mystery propellers that I got in the mail today, courtesy of Newbie Drone, or HQ perhaps, via Newbie Drone. These are the prototypes for the new 3D props that HQ is coming out with. Now, I can't get too detailed with them, but we are going to kind of compare them, and I'll show you a little bit of flight footage with the Gym Fans and then with these. So, let's open the box and see what we got here. Newbie Drone is down in San Diego, and I'm just in Temecula. It's not that far. And I've flown with Zoe a couple of times. She's really cool. And a couple of the guys there at Newbie Drone. So they reached out to me and asked if I would like to try them. And I said, yes, very much yes. As a matter of fact, I don't know if it's just coincidence or what, but I had earlier that day, like within a few hours, contacted HQ Prop on Instagram because I saw their post, and I said, hey, I would absolutely freaking love to actually, I think it was Zoe's video as well, because she did a video, but I said, hey, I would absolutely love to try those new props out. But later that day, one of the guys from Newbie Drone was like, hey. So in the box, we got some badass Newbie Drone stickers. These are some newer ones that I haven't seen personally yet. Always good to have new stickers. So, and then we have our packing slip. Thank you from Newbie Drone. Nice. And props. Ooh, okay. So, I'm not really supposed to show these off too much up close, so you get to see them through the bag. They're kind of naturally blurred that way. They are definitely a much different blade profile than the Gym Fans. They look like they're probably about the same pitch, maybe just a tiny, well, I don't know. Maybe about the same pitch, but it looks like there's a little bit more to the blade design there. They're not quite the same. And they're definitely not quite as squared off as these guys. So you can see these things are really, they're almost paddle-like. They don't seem like they'd be as efficient as they are, even. But These definitely seem like they'll be a little more efficient. That's what they look like to me. They look a little more efficient. Let's see. Looks like there's two sets in here as well. So that's cool. That's perfect. They're definitely lighter. I think that's about all I'm gonna say. They're a little lighter, and there's a little bit more to the blade design. They're definitely symmetrical though. So, that's my initial thoughts. They seem like they'll be legit. As long as they maintain that HQ durability, I'm slightly suspicious of this material. So, what we're gonna do, what I wanna do, is we're gonna fly a pack with the gym pen, kinda older style 3D. 5-inch. We're gonna fly a pack with the Schmanzy top secret-ish prototype HQ props. And if I can find like a link to that Instagram post, or if I can find that Instagram post, I'll put a link there as well so you can check it out on HQ stuff. If you like HQ props and you like 3D, then you're likely going to be really excited about this. I think HQ might be onto something, but let's put them on the CL1 now and test them out and see if they really are onto something.
Let's get to work! Blow it all on me. I ain't nothing but a smart ass drinking from an empty glass. I'm as crazy as a tree. Watch your hurry.
So that was the first pack on the HQ props, the new prototype props. They weren't bad. They flew really smooth. I liked that, but they didn't feel like they had as much thrust. I felt like I was at higher throttle a lot of the time, and it's possible that's my quad. So we'll see when we compare to the Gemfan 3D props, you know, whether that's the CL1 being the CL1 or if that's the props. I don't know if it was just me flying today, but I did feel more confident inverted with them. I almost felt more confident inverted than not inverted with them. But, they seem pretty durable. I crashed two decent times, nothing super crazy, but one was hard enough to knock a bell off, and both of them popped the camera wire off. One of them was tweaked just a teeny bit. Let's see here. And I just kind of went neat and bent it back, and it seemed to just pop right back in. This one's a little teeny bit, and you know, you got a couple little tiny nicks, but actually overall, pretty good overall. I know that the Gemfan props tend to hold up pretty good, so we'll have to try them out and or see how these hold up more long term, I guess. So we'll fly a pack with the Gemfans, and then I'll probably put these back on and fly them for a little while and see what happens. So we got the Gemfan 3D props on. We're going to rip a pack with those and see how they feel different or the same or better or worse or just as good. So, we, a little bit of a crash there. Did bend two of the props pretty good. And full disclosure, these are used. They're this set of props. They're in pretty good shape, though. They weren't all beat up. None of them were bent or anything. So, bent two pretty good.
One is pretty good, and one you may have heard lost a blade. So those are the gem fans. I don't think I'm gonna finish that pack, since I am a little more familiar with them anyway. So the gem fans, they definitely feel like they have more thrust, which might be why they feel like they have a teeny bit less control, but you can kind of catch yourself a little easier, if that makes sense, you know, like when you're diving, or if you're, you know, transitioning and you're really low and things like that. It's hard to say which ones I really like better, but after one pack, I haven't flown 3D in a little while either, so this is kind of nice, you know. While I am familiar with the gem fans, 3D is a little bit foreign still, because I'm still kind of new and I haven't flown for a couple weeks 3D, so I don't know, it's interesting. I think I like the new HQs a little better. I think they need to make them just a hair beefier and they would be perfect. I'm not sure how to do that. If they could give them just a hair more thrust, and maybe just a little bit, make them a little bit more stout and less flexible, I guess, because they seem a little bit flexible. So that would be what I would recommend to HQ, I think, is the biggest thing, is give them just a hair more punch, and like, not, they really don't need that much, but just a little bit, because I was watching the OSD and I was at about 30% throttle at more or less a hover with the HQs, and about 25-ish with the gem fans, which 25 is about where the CL1 will hover with, I don't know, like Cyclones, like 5047s or whatever. So just a hair more thrust and I think they're pretty locked. So I'm digging the new HQs. I can't wait for them to release them. HQ, if you would like to send me some more, by all means, send me as many as you're willing to send me, and I will fly the shit out of them, because I do like them. I definitely felt like I had more control, whether that's some psychosomatic thing or not, they felt more locked and precise and smooth, and I think you'll see that in the video, so, I think you'll have seen that in the video. So, there you go, guys. I'm going to shoot back in, and we'll get just a brief wrap-up there. All right, guys. So, hopefully you enjoyed that video, or this video, and hopefully it was informative. Hopefully it helped you out. Hopefully you're excited for the new HQ 3D props, because I certainly am. I think I'm digging them. I definitely think I'm digging them. I'm going to keep flying them for the next few days. excuse me. And I think I'll post some updates and stuff on the Insta. Just kind of talking about how much I like them and that kind of stuff. Or if I've changed my mind. So you can always follow me there on my Instagram. That's @highspeedimagery. And you can follow along and see the developments. So, like I said, they are still prototypes, so I can only give up so much stuff. I'm super happy to be involved in testing these. Again, thanks for watching, guys. If you stuck all the way to the end, I really appreciate it. If you're not subscribed, I would really appreciate that as well. Go ahead and drop a like if you enjoyed it. If you didn't, I guess go ahead and dislike it. And leave some comments, questions. I'll answer anything that I can. and you guys have a great day. Fly safe. Don't drink and drive.
Welcome.